Welcome back to the Six on Your Side Hot Seat. Our guests, Alvin L. Richard Jr., owner of Richard's Disposal, Inc., and Mr. Jimmy Woods, owner of Metro Disposal. Again, we extended an invitation to Stacey Head to be here, but she declined. How concerned are you, gentlemen, that your contracts might not pass muster under the Inspector General's office? Let's start with you, Mr. Woods.
I'm not concerned at all, Norman. These contracts were procured through the state of Louisiana public bid laws. The process was followed based on those laws as governed by the state of Louisiana, and we complied with that every step of the way. In fact, I welcome the OIG's review of these contracts and the procurement process, and finally, hopefully once and for all, it would put to bed the accusations that have been made by certain elected officials.
How surprised were you, Mr. Richard, if at all, that your contract was chosen to be reviewed by the OIG?
We're not surprised. We've been reviewed and analyzed since the time we got the contracts 3 years ago, and what does aggravate me is to say we're in our third year, going into the fourth year of our contract, and every year with the budget hearing, we have to go through the same issues. And to say the OIG findings, they weren't used, and as some of the council members say, it's apple to apples. It was a different perspective that they looked at versus what we do for the city and how we charge the city.
Let's revisit that then, Mr. Woods. You're talking about the contract process. You're talking about the bid process and how it was handled and how it differentiates between what happened here in New Orleans Parish and what happened in Jefferson Parish.
Right. Absolutely. The city of New Orleans elected to go through a public bid, which means it was governed by state bid laws. They did that. Jefferson Parish and most other municipalities in the state, and for that matter, this region, normally request garbage services through a request for proposal, which would allow that governing body to come in and select a couple of contractors and negotiate the terms and the prices of the services for some extended period of time. The city, I believe, for the sake of transparency, decided that they were not going to call in anybody and just negotiate, come and put your best number on the table and move forward from there. And that's what we did. So it was very as transparent as a process could possibly be.
Mr. Richard, do you get the impression that you're being singled out? Some have suggested that you're being scrutinized simply because you're a minority.
To put it in those terms is very close, because I don't understand if the service is as good as what the city says it is. Nobody's complaining. We have good records. We're doing the job as best it could be done. And every year we go through the same things. We're charging too much. We're doing this. The eight cities that the city chose or the OIG chose to verify our charges and saying that we charge too much, it wasn't apples to apples. They did on per person. We charge per home. And then charging per home is it made it seems like these people didn't charge per home, but we do. And they're saying it's obvious that we charge more.
Well, what is the difference then in charging per person and charging per home? Why would you charge per home when other contractors in other cities are charging per person?
That's not a true statement on that, because the other cities are charging per home, but the OIG chose to use that because that came out to be a higher number, and it just made us look like we were going higher than the rest. However, you have to look at it. What is in the $41 million that the sanitation budget is? We say we have 311,853 citizens in New Orleans. We looking at that number divided into the sanitation number, and that's how you came out with the mean. So when they say $134 per person, that's how they got it. Now, how could that be charged against the two contractors when we don't collect any homes larger than a fourplex? There's all kind of homes in the apartment buildings, the condos, and the rest. But you use the whole municipality to charge against these two contractors. You have the French Quarters. We left those numbers out. There's 6,500 homes there.
Because that's another contractor.
That's another contractor. But they're still homes. I'm not talking about the contractor at all. I'm only talking about the people that live there. So how many people do you have in that area that's still considered on our dime that is saying, this is what you have, 311,000, that's the entire city of New Orleans population, voted against the two contractors? And I think that's inaccurate. Then when we go back and we looked at it, I've did some homework on this thing. And what we did in the last 2 weeks is scrutinize this. Of the contracts in the cities that they have the comparisons. All of them are collected by the municipalities, except three. That's Toledo, New Orleans, and Baton Rouge. That's the only three of those nine that have private contractors. All of those municipalities have their own landfills. All of them charge per household, and they're much higher than what we charge here in the city. Plus, a lot of them only have once-a-week service. But nobody's saying what the comparisons is, and it's not fair for me to sit here to try to analyze what the OIG has put before you, because we don't have all the facts and the figures. We don't know what the services are. We don't know what they charge. Are they supplementing the residents as we do here? We don't have any of that information. All we have is a chart that shows that we higher than the other comparable cities.
You mentioned once-a-week collection. There's been a suggestion that a way to get around the budget deficit that the city's facing is that the city of New Orleans go to once-a-week garbage collection. What happens then if that in fact occurs, Mr. Woods?
I guess from a practical standpoint, as contractors, Norman, our cost is fixed, and we amortized our cost on this contract throughout the term of the contract. So, for instance, Mr. Richards mentioned we bought over 100,000 quarts at a cost of $8 million. That cost is spread over the term of the contract. So the number of trucks that is required to do this service is fixed. So all our costs basically are fixed. There could be
So you're saying it's not going to make a difference whether you pick up once a week or twice a week?
It'll be minimal.
The cost is going to be the same?
That is, in fact, it may cost the contractors more money because basically the landfills are open only for a certain window of time during the day. And if you have to, the amount of garbage in the city, let me put it this way, the amount of garbage in the city is going to stay the same. One household generates approximately 1.5 tons a year. That amount of garbage is going to stay the same. So whether or not you pass down that street once a week or twice a week, it's going to take you the same amount of time to get it off the street.
So there'll be no difference in the cost, Mr. Richards.
One council member mentioned that Dallas has gone from twice a week to once a week. So we did some homework on that. And what we found out was Dallas charges $22.79 per home. They said that they're going to save the residents some money. The actual savings per resident is 64 cents, and the cost still goes to $22.02. There's still no significant difference in it because you're collecting the same amount of garbage. And then consider that we went to once a week. How many states or unions that we have that compares to New Orleans in the southeast region? We eat crawfish. We eat a lot of seafood. We put that in a garbage can. How can you haul that once a week? It doesn't suit. It's not like in the old days where your parents used to take the seafood and put it in the refrigerator, freeze it until the garbage man passed. That's not done anymore. And now the city is cleaner than it's ever been. And now we're talking about destroying a system that actually works.
Well, gentlemen, I think this is probably an issue that we're going to be revisiting from time to time. Thank you for being here. We've run out of time.
We appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
You're welcome. That concludes this week's segment of The Hot Seat. Thank you both for being here. Now back to the news desk.